Hey, Channel Fireball people, Lost Origins is out and I want to run you through the best new decks in this format. Let's go! So coming in at number 5, I have the sort of Lost Zone majority single prize kind of a deck that revolves around this Cramorant really, which when there's 4 Pokemon in the Lost Zone, it can attack for free, and its attack does, you know, 110 damage, not too bad. In combination with Choice Belt, that's getting towards 2-shot territories and all that good stuff. So how are we getting cards in the Lost Zone? Well, Comfey with its flower selecting ability lets you look at the top 2 cards of your deck, put one in your hand, and then put one in the Lost Zone. Not too bad in combination with switching cards such as Escape Rope and Scoop Up Nets. You can reuse this multiple times and maybe even get to 4 cards in Lost Zone without even needing to play a supporter, which is Chorus, which lets you look at the top 5 cards of your deck, put 3 in your hand, and put 2 into the Lost Zone. Not too bad if you ask me. So let me tell you about some of these other attackers then. So we've got Disabler, which is really good, which when for 1 psychic energy, as long as you have 10 cards in your Lost Zone, you can put 12 damage counters on your opponent's Pokemon in any way you like. This is a little bit crazy, to be honest with you. That is insane damage spread, no doubt about that. So there are 2 main Lost Zone attackers, right? Then we've got the Miltank here, that Miracle Body ability, which prevents all damage done to it via V Pokemon. Not too bad, and its attack route is pretty decent. For 2 energy, you do Tempest 30 for each bench Pokemon your opponent has in place. So Miltank is always, you know, can cause problems for decks. Some decks don't even have an answer to it. And in that case, you can just send up your Miltank and hopefully win the game from there. We also see this Snorlax was a really interesting card, which I didn't foresee being played at all, but it's actually been doing pretty good. Basic Pokemon 150 HP with its attack Thumping Snore. That's a very good attack name. For 3 colorless energy, you do 180 damage, then it goes to sleep. But you have to flip 2 coins, and both of them has to be heads for you to wake up. Okay, so the attack isn't really that great, but it does do 180 damage on a 1 prize Pokemon. But how are we going to get these 3 energies attached, I hear you ask? Well, when you have 7 cards in your Lost Zone, you can use Mirage Gate, which lets you get 2 basic energies from your deck of different colors and attach them to your Pokemon any way you like. So Snorlax is a target for that Mirage Gate, and so is Radiant Charizard, our other heavy hitter of the deck, which for 5 energy does 250 damage. Now that sounds really high energy cost, and that's because it is, but 250 damage is really worth it. However, that Excited Heart ability actually knocks off a colorless for each prize card your opponent has taken, meaning Combustion Blast can get to the point where it's being, you can use it for like 1 fire energy at a minimum, or you can start using it for like 3 energies in total, and in that case you can just use Mirage Gate to get there. And this list really wants to try and reuse that Radiant Zard as much as possible. That's why you see the Ordinary Rod, that's why you see the Clara as well, where there are 2 copies of Clara. So yeah, Lost Vacuum is another way you can get cards in the Lost Zone as well, which lets you discard a card from your hand, or put a card into the Lost Zone I should say, and then you get a Stadium or Tour card and put that into the Lost Zone. So yeah, pretty good deck, singleton deck. The only other Pokemon here that I don't really agree with, but it is here in this list, is the Drapion V, really good against Mew, because through its ability, you can knock off 1 attack cost for each Fusion Strike Pokemon, Rapid Strike Pokemon, or Single Strike Pokemon your opponent has in play, and its attack is for 4 colorless, so against Mew VMAX, you can normally attack for free, and its attack is 190 damage, and that's good because Mew is weak to Dark, meaning that this Drapion can one-shot Mew VMAX, which is pretty good. And, you know, if the Mew VMAX player doesn't, you know, Lost City away the Drapion, in this list you can just claw for it back and slam into Mew VMAX. But against everything else, if you lead it, it is a 2 prize Pokemon that is quite costly. But, you know, it's really good against Mew. That's our number 5 deck. What's at number 4? Coming in at number 4, we have Guja V-Star. Real interesting card, right? A V-Star Pokemon, 270 HP, with his attack Rolling Iron. For water, metal, colorless, you do 200 damage, and this Pokemon takes 80 less damage from your opponent's attacks next turn. And its V-Star power lets you completely heal all damage from it. So you can see where this deck is trying to go. We're going to try and get those energies on and just reduce damage as much as possible. Tank, tank, tank. And then when we get close to being KO'd, you can just heal it all off. So in order to get these energies on in this list, we are playing the Mirage Gate, which we just saw. So we're playing a sort of similar Lost Zone engine with a Comp Phase and a Chorus. We see the Cramorant as well, some early pressure. And we do see the Moonlight Shuriken Radiant Greninja here, which says you discard an energy card and draw 2. However, in this list, you can actually attack with it as well, because Mirage Gate can attach to it, meaning that Moonlight Shuriken does 90 to 2 of your opponent's Pokemon. Never a bad attack. Now, I quite like this list. We've got the Crystal Cave that heals 30 from your Dragon types. I'd like to see maybe a couple more of them. But apart from that, we see the Melanies as well, which is a really good rare to get energy on. Then you grab a water from your discard pile, attach it to one of your V Pokemon, and then draw three. A very good way of getting that Goodra involved quite early without having to rely on the Mirage Gate shenanigans, which I quite like, if I'm honest. So yeah, this list doesn't play much healing. I think I've seen some other lists that play a bit more healing, but I think that's fine. Just trying to force your opponent to go through three of these Goodras could be and will be quite hard, especially with that V-Star power. You're essentially making your opponent go through four, and that sounds quite hard to me. And 200 is a pretty scary number, if you ask me. That's Goodra V-Star. So number three. Coming at number three, we have Gabe Smart's Zoroark list. Zoroark V-Star is a V-Star Pokemon, 270 HP, with its attacks Ticking Curse, which is 50 for each one of your Pokemon that has damage counters on. We'll get to how we're getting those damage counters on in a second. And then we've got our V-Star power, is it Phantom Star, which lets you discard your hand and draw 7, which means if you play a Professor's Research and use that Phantom Star, you're actually seeing 14 cards in that turn. Pretty crazy, and that's one reason as to why Hisuian Zoroark has gone from the underrated all the way up to being a serious contender now, because, you know, for one energy attached from that double turbo range, you're swinging for 250, even up to 300 upwards amount of damage. So how are we getting these damage counters into play? Well, two ways. The first and most straightforward way is the Gape Jaw Bog Stage, and we see there is a 4 count, which when your basic Pokemon gets put into play, put 2 damage counters on that Pokemon, both yours and your opponent, so a little bit of chip damage for your opponent there as well. And we also have this Gengar with its Netherworld Gate ability. When it's in a discard pile, you can put it onto your bench and put 3 damage counters on this Pokemon. So you can see that's how we're getting damage into play. We've even got the Damage Pump item card, which actually moves 2 damage counters from one Pokemon to another, which is really, really good. We also see the Dunsparce here, which lets you remove Corolla's Pokemon's weakness, so the Zoroark now has no weakness. And we see the Raging Hawlucha, that big match ability, which lets you hit V-Maxes for an extra 30 damage. We even see the Bibarel here, which lets you draw up to 5 cards as well. So the potential to draw a ton of cards in this list is insane, and that's kind of necessary when you have to find double turbos to attack. There's no real way to search them out. You just have to draw into them. But that's what makes this deck so good. You can just churn through your deck so much and be super consistent at hitting that 200 up damage. However, the deck can be a little bit linear. You know, all it can do really is just punch hard in the face. But Zoroark does it pretty well, and that's one good way to take prizes, to punch hard and punch fast. We see that's how Mew VMAX tends to win games, right, just from being super oppressive early on. And I see no reason why this deck can't do that as well. So number two. Coming in at number two, we have Zach Lesage's Palkia Kyurem VMAX deck. And before the set came out, it was always that debate, what's better, Kyurem or Ice Rider? And we're seeing now that Kyurem, at least for now, is taking that spotlight as being a Palkia sort of partner. Let me show you why. So Kyurem VMAX is a VMAX Pokemon, 330 HP. With its ability Glaciated World, you can discard top card of your deck. If it's an energy, you can attach it. That's pretty crazy. Water already has a ton of acceleration, right? By Palkia, Melanie, all of that stuff. And now you have another way. But this way works really good if you attack as well. Max Frost for free water energy. You can discard any amount of water energy you like. There's 120 plus 50 for each water you discard. Endless damage cap. And that's something that Ice Rider hasn't got. If you want to start Oko and VMAX Pokemon with Ice Rider, you have to play like Choice Belt, Leon, maybe even a Raging Hawlucha. However, in this, you just load up to your 4 or 5 energy in play and you just slam them all off and you're KOing whatever is in your face. And like I said, you know, with Palkia's V-Star ability Star Portal, which lets you get 3 waters from your discard pile and attach into your Pokemon, you can make this cure and start doing some crazy, crazy things. That's why we see the 2 copies of Oranguru there, because you swap your top deck with a card from your hand, meaning you can just Oranguru water to the top, Glaciated World, Melanie, Star Portal, all of a sudden this cure has like 4 or 5 energy on it, and you can slap something super, super hard. And don't forget, you can use multiple Kyurems, so you can do 2, maybe even 3 Glaciated Worlds all in a turn and start slamming stuff. And 330 is a big number. A lot of stuff can sort of reach that 310 range, but 330 HP, not a lot can reach that. So Kyurem should be sticking around. It's not too unfeasible for your Kyurem to take 2, 4, maybe even 6 prizes on its own. And when it goes down, you can even use Palkia of its Subspace World Attack, which is a 60 plus 20 for each bench Pokemon you have in play, just to clean up on like a little 2 prize Pokemon, such as like a Crobat. or something like this. Here we also see the Empoleon V with that Emperor Eyes ability, which shuts off your opponent's basic Pokemon without a rule box abilities. So no Comfeys, no Regis, any of that stuff. Is a pretty good card if you ask me. And yeah, I'm a big fan of this. I can't wait to try it out myself. What's at number one? So coming in at number one is the big, bad, scary deck of the format, Giratina V-Star. V-Star Pokemon 280 HP with the attack Lost Impact for Grass, Psychic, Colorless. You do 280 damage and you can return two energies from your Pokemon to the Lost Zone. 280 is a great break point that KOs all the V-Star Pokemon, things you love to see. And then his GX attack is also pretty crazy. For, what is it? For Grass, Psychic, Star Requiem. As long as you have 10 cards in your Lost Zone, your opponent's active is KO'd. Auto KO, doesn't matter how much HP they've got, it just KOs them. Obviously, we're playing a Lost Zone engine here, so we've got the Comfeys, we've got the Chorus Experiments, all the switching cards to go with that. We also see the Drapion here for the Mew matchup, because Mew can be a little bit hard to navigate if you're a Giratina player. So the Drapion here, you know, in combination with the ordinary rods, hopefully you can just reuse that Drapion two times. We've got the Sableye again, we've got the Cramorant, we've got the Umineon, so you can grab a supporter. I quite like this list, to be honest. I found the early list of Giratina to be a little bit clunky, and I can see how this list is opting to get around that. One thing I like about the Giratina list though is just how versatile it is. You've got the Crime right there for a one prize attacker, you've got the Sableye for some clean up and spread, you've got the Giratina that has a heavy hitting attack and an auto KO attack as well. And we even see the Lost Cities here as well, which lets you get a little bit extra cards in the Lost Zone, meaning if your opponent KOs your Cramorant, it actually goes into the Lost Zone, hopefully get into your Mirage Gates a lot sooner. I quite like this list, and I reckon you should be taking all these decks pretty seriously. Let me know what you think. If you're gonna buy any of these cards, do it from Channel Fireball and use my code HOTCHOCK, okay? But thanks for watching. Let me know what you want to see me cover, and I'll see you next time.